Carbone workflow. This video will show the basic Carbone workflow, including creating a compositional fluid model and matching it with laboratory data. Launch Carbone. Click New to start a new document. Name the document PVT-EX01 and leave the standard conditions as default. Under General Characteristics of the field, enter Reservoir Temperature and Reservoir Pressure. Click Create. The document browser on the left lists the different document options. Select the General Parameters node in the browser and enter values for the minimum pressure and maximum pressure. Minimum and maximum pressures indicate the span of pressure that tables, simulations, and exports will use by default. These values are not required in any fluid modeling calculations. Click Apply and Update All Fluids in the prompt at the top right. Click OK to validate. The New button at the top left creates new objects including fluid, lab data, experiment, and/or objective function. Click on New. Select EOS Fluid to initialize a new compositional fluid object. Call it Oil and click on Next. In the subsequent page, accept the pre-filled values for standard and reservoir conditions and click on Next. Define the EOS parameters. Keep modified Pang-Robinson EOS model with volume correction for equilibrium calculations and the LBC correlation for viscosity. For plus fraction correlation, select 2-Edmeister, accepting the remaining choices as default and click on Next. The penultimate step in creating a new fluid involves selecting fluid components. In this illustration, components will be picked from the standard scenario. Select N2, CO2, and C1 to C11 by clicking on the plus button next to each component. This adds these components to the selection list. Components in blue are pure components with fixed properties. Components from .C6 and above are pseudocomponents. Their properties, molar weight, specific gravity, and boiling point, can be modified at low time and all other properties are recomputed automatically. Pseudocomponent properties can also be modified once the fluid is created, either manually or as part of a regression. Click on Next. The last step is to define fluid composition and primary properties of pseudocomponents. Change the name of the heaviest pseudocomponent to .C11+. Fluid composition can be entered manually, component by component, or pasted from clipboard. The latter option is used for this illustration. Input 303 for molar weight for .C11+. This clears the specific gravity and boiling point values from the table. These will be recomputed upon validation using the 2-Edmeister correlation. Click on Create. The fluid is added to the process tree and in the document browser on the left. Select the fluid in the process tree. At the top of the application window, there is a breadcrumbs trail of the selected element, which allows quick access to multiple elements in a particular workflow. Three additional nodes will appear at the top: Model Settings, Phase Envelope and Flash, and EOS Consistency. The Model Setting page shows the fluid composition, component properties, and binary interaction coefficients for the selected fluid. Values in blue may be edited by users. Once a value is edited, related values may be recomputed using the Recompute button. The EOS Parameters button allows users to view or edit the current EOS parameters. In the Phase Envelope and Flash page, Phase Envelope is automatically generated based on the given fluid composition and EOS parameters. The vertical line is between the minimum and maximum pressures defined earlier, while the reservoir pressure is shown as a black circle. The Kronkondentherm and Kronkonden bar and critical point are displayed in a table to the right of the phase envelope. The drop-down list below the table allows the user to compare phase envelopes of multiple fluids. Flash results at reservoir and standard conditions are listed below the phase envelope. The results show that the current fluid definition entails a single-phase oil at reservoir conditions with a saturation pressure of 3117.5 PSIA. The EOS consistency page offers plots to verify the consistency of the EOS model. The next step is to load lab data. Move to the workflow page, click on New, click on Lab Data. Accept the default inputs in the subsequent page and click on Finish. This creates a lab data node in the document browser under which the experiment can be added. Add a new experiment under the existing lab data node. In the subsequent page, keep CCE selected in the type of experiment list and keep the default name. Pressure and total relative volume are the default input parameters and appear in the list on the right. Add oil density to the list from the available parameters list by clicking on the plus button next to oil density in the list on the left. Click on Next to proceed. Copy the CCE data from the PVT report and paste it into the form. Click on Create. The document browser on the left shows CCE under lab data. In addition, since this lab data is associated to oil fluid, it is also listed under oil fluid. A saturation pressure experiment containing the saturation pressure and oil density at saturation has been automatically created, picking the values from the CCE table where the total relative volume equals 1. In the process tree, the fluid box is updated with the mean error between the simulated and measured data based on the quality indicator set to the automatic objective function by default. Hovering the cursor over the error label pops up a radar plot showing the mean error for each measure. The automatic objective function includes all data associated to the fluid. Select the oil fluid in the process tree. In addition to the three pages shown earlier, a match node will appear at the top. Click on it to display the match page. Tables and plots are generated automatically, showing the comparison between the model and the lab data for total relative volume and oil density. The table at the top displays the total mean error for each measurement. Select lab data, saturation pressure, from the breadcrumbs trail at the top. The match page will be updated and show the simulated and measured properties for the automatically created saturation pressure experiment. A difference is observed between the simulated and measured saturation pressure and oil at saturation density. These measurements are likely candidates for regression later. Instead of using the option menu for lab data, click on New at the top. Under the Experimental Data panel, click on Experiment for another way to load experimental data. Add differential liberation data in much the same way as CCE. Select differential liberation as type of experiment. Keep the default name. Remove gas gravity from selected parameters and add gas compressibility factor to the selected parameters list. Copy the differential liberation table and paste it into the form. Click on Create. Select lab data DL from the breadcrumbs trail at the top. Simulated and measured properties for the differential liberation experiment are shown. Input a new set of viscosity data. Under the Lab Data menu, click on Add Experiment. Leave the type of experiment as CCE. Call the experiment Oil Viscosity. Remove Total Relative Volume from selected parameters and add Oil Viscosity. Copy the viscosity table and paste it into the form. Click on Create. Select lab data, oil viscosity from the breadcrumbs trail at the top to compare the simulated and measured lab data. The simulated data show significant deviation from the measured lab data. Go through a series of regressions to improve the match. Return to the workflow page. Select the oil fluid, click on spread operator, and select regression from the list of options. Attempt to match on the saturation pressure and RS measured in the differential liberation experiment. Call the fluid PSAT plus RS and keep the remaining selections and values as default. Click on Next. Instead of regressing on TC and PC of all components independently, use a common multiplier on them. Define the objective function to use in the regression. An objective function is a collection of lab data points and relative weights to use in any regression. Change the objective function name to PSAT plus RS. Select saturation pressure and RS in the available targets list and add them to the selected targets list. Click on Create. Once the regression is complete, click on the Process icon to see detailed information in a slide-out page to the right. The radar plot shows the original mean error calculations in red. The variables table shows the regression setup and the final values. The target and match table shows a good match for the two regression targets. Scroll down further to see the plot of evolution of the objective function and logs. In the workflow page, select PSAT plus RS fluid and click on Match at the top. To compare between the match before and after regression, extend the drop-down list and select Oil. Switch to the saturation pressure experiment to compare the two fluids against measured data. The mean relative error table shows significant improvement for PSAT plus RS. Switch to the DL experiment to compare the two fluids against measured data. The mean relative error table shows significant improvement for PSAT plus RS. The next step will be to improve the density match. Return to the workflow page. Select the PSAT plus RS fluid in the process tree. Click on the spread operator and select regression from the list of options. Call this fluid densities and keep the remaining selections and values as default. Click on Next. Select the volume correction node in the list on the left and add them to the regression variables. Leave the default range and click on Next. A new objective function will be defined for this regression. Click on Define Objective Function and call it Densities. Select the Oil Density node under CCE and DL Experiments and move them to the selected targets list. Click on Create. While the regression is running, hovering over the gear icon in the process tree will show the evolution of the objective function in a pop-up box. When the regression is complete, go to the match page and compare PSAT plus RS and densities fluids against measured CCE and DL density data. Next, improve the viscosity match. Switch back to the workflow page. Select the densities fluid in the process tree. Click on the spread operator and select regression from the list of options. Call this fluid viscosity, and this time select viscosity model for the regression type. Click on Next. For critical volumes, set a constant on all multiplier. Expand the LBC node and select A4. Move the two nodes on the list to the right. Leave the ranges as default and click on Next. Call the new objective function viscosities. Select all viscosity data and move it to the list of selected targets. Click on Create. Once the regression is complete, select viscosity fluid. Go to the match page and compare this fluid with the original fluid oil. Switch to the oil viscosity experiment. To compare the phase envelopes between the original and final fluids, switch to the phase envelope and flash page. Select oil in the compare with drop-down list. Go back to the workflow page. The last step is to export the tuned fluid for use in any compositional modeling package. Move the cursor over the viscosity fluid node, click on the spread operator, and select export. To export an Eclipse compositional format, select Eclipse EOS. Select the output units and click on OK. Choose any location on disk to save the file to. Open the file in any text editor to view its content. This concludes the session on the basic Carbone workflow. In addition to simulation and matching of experiments, other available processes include multi-fluid regression, separation, lumping, split, mixer, and compositional gradient. Carbone also has a built-in help, which may be used to read about the different options available. This concludes the session